He would make sport of it and torment the poor lady worse.
She is an excellent, sweet lady,
and exceedingly wise in all things but loving Benedict.
I pray you, tell Benedict of it, and hear what he will say.
Were it good, think you?
Hero says she will die if he love her not, and she will die ere she make him love no, and she will die if he woo her, rather than she obey one breath of her accustomed crossness.
She doth well. If she should make tender of her love, 'tis very possible he'll scorn it, for the man, as you know all, hath a contemptible spirit. But shall we go seek Benedict and tell him of her love?
Never tell him. Let her wear it out with good counsel.
Nay, that is possible. She may wear her heart out first.
We will hear further of it by your daughter. Let it cool while. I love Benedict well, but I wish he would modestly examine himself to see how unworthy he is of so young a lady.
My friends, we want dinner is ready.
If he do not dote on her now, I will never trust my expectations.
Let the same that be spread for her that your daughter and her gentleman must carry. Let us then wish to call him to dinner.
Yes.
This can be no trick. They have truth of this from here. Beatrice, pull up me. I hear how it's absurd. They say I will bear myself proudly. They say, too, that she'd rather die than give any friend of affection. I did never think to marry. I must not seem proud. They say the lady is fair. 'Tis the truth, and wise, but for loving me. By my troth, I will be horribly in love with her. I have railed so long against marriage, but doth not the appetite alter? The world must be peopled! When I said I would die a bachelor, I did not think I should live till I were married. Here comes Beatrice, by the station's a fair lady. I do spice so much love her.
Against my will, I am sent bid you come into dinner.
Ah, I thank you, pretty fair.
I took no more pains for those things than you take pains to thank me. If it had been painful, I would not have come.
You take pleasure then in the message.
Yea, just so much as you might take upon a knife's point. You have no stomach, sir? Fare you well.
Ha! Against my will, I sit bid you come into dinner. There's a double meaning in that.
Nature never turns a woman's heart to outer stuff, and that would be it.
If I see anything tonight, I should not marry her. Tomorrow, in the congregation where I should wed, there was shame her.
Question.
I think your other shoes were better.
No, good Meg.
I'll wear none but these.
And God give me joy to wear them.
I'll offend nobody but ask Beatrice, here she comes.
Good morrow, Cuz.
Good morrow, sweet hero.
Why, how now? Do you speak in the sick tune?
I am out of all other tune, methinks.
Tis almost 5 o'clock, cousin. Tis time you were ready.
By my troth, I am exceeding ill.
These gloves that Claudio sent me, they're an excellent perfume.
I am stuffed, cousin. I cannot smell.
A maid am stuffed? There's good news pinching a cold. Doth my wit become you rarely?
It is not seen enough you should wear in your cap. By my troth, I am sick.
Get you some of this distilled Carvus Benedictus. It is the only thing for a qual.
Benedictus! Why, Benedictus? You have some moral in this, Benedictus.
Moral?
No,
why, my troth, I have no moral meaning. You may think, perchance, that I think that you are in love. Nay, I am not such a fool to think that you are in love, or that you will be in love, or that you can be in love. Yet, Benedict swore he would never marry, and now, in spite of his heart, he needs to do that grudging. How you may be converted, I know not, but methinks you look with your eyes as other women do.
What pace is this that thy tongue keeps?
Not a false scowl.
Hero, withdraw! Pedro, Claudio, Benedict, and all are come to fetch you be wed.
Help me to dress, good cuz, Meg, Ursula.
You will go.